spent a lot of time driving a haybine, cutting hay on a Colorado ranch. You sit high above the field, and you can see what got wet and what didn't. It's a pretty good place to think about water. The water that irrigates those fields comes from 14,000-foot mountains nearby. It flows back into the stream and eventually reaches the Colorado River. I often used to wonder how long it would take a drop of that water to reach the sea. As a boy, 20 to 40 years seemed like a pretty good estimate. But as I got older and saw those giant seas of the desert, like Lake Powell and Lake Mead, forever seemed like a more accurate time frame. So I decided to see for myself where exactly our irrigation water goes. In the headwaters of Rocky Mountain National Park, Colorado, I joined my friend John Waterman. John shared a curiosity about the issue as well and decided to paddle the entire length of the river. But sometimes it's hard to see the river when you're in it. So I chose to focus my cameras above the action. This remarkable body of water travels 1,450 miles across 7 states and 2 countries. It supports 30 million people and countless creatures across the semi-arid West. The reality is today the river doesn't make the sea. My estimate forever for how long a drop of our irrigation water would take to return back to the ocean is far more accurate than I could ever imagine.
Where are we? What are we doing to ourselves, Pete?
We're trying to navigate our way down what was once the Colorado River.
As the river grows in length, it shrinks in volume. And I was surprised to see exactly where all the water goes. To learn more about why the majestic and mighty Colorado River runs dry, look for our book at distributors nationwide.